This is Fred, your friendly neighborhood realtor here in Orlando, Florida. This week I'm going to talk to you about the mortgage rates for the week ending May 3rd, 2024. This past week, the Fed, part of their periodic meetings that they meet during the year, did meet, and they actually decided not to raise the raise or lower the prime rate, which the prime rate helps kind of what's going to happen with the mortgage rates. Since they didn't lower them, mortgage rates are still basically pretty high, staying right around the same. The good news was that they did say they did not anticipate another rate hike coming, even though we've had some high inflationary numbers. So that is actually good things for the long term. It is going to wait and see whether they actually do reduce the rates at some point this year. I'm a little skeptical about they are. If they do it, it's going to be the very tail end of the year, perhaps the last quarter of the year at best. So what did the rates get you this week? Bankrate.com actually has the 30-year fixed conventional mortgage at 7.36%, which is up 4 basis points and is going to cost you approximately $689 per $100,000. They're saying that this is actually up about a little over $4 per month as far as your payment goes. And I've actually seen some sites where they're saying the average is at 7.91%. So we're actually getting close to 8% there. Your 15-year fixed conventional mortgage, which I'm a big fan of, mostly because you build equity faster and also that you save a lot of money, thousands of dollars on your mortgage cost over the life of the loan. Now, at 6.76%, it is up 5 basis points from last week, and it is per $100,000 going to cost you approximately $885. So it is a big increase, but the thing of it is if you're able to do it, it could actually save you a lot of money over the long term. Now, the 5-1 adjustable rate mortgage, 5-1 ARM, is up 4 basis points at 6.82%, so approximately $653 per $100,000. Now, the key thing to watch with the adjustable rate mortgages is this. When we've looked at the principal and interest payment for your rates versus also your APR, your annual percentage rate, which has actually got all your costs for your loan and everything else built in, you're finding with the ARM that the APR is a good distance or a good jump up. So that 5-1 ARM may not be actually what's going to be the most economical, but that rate is going to stay for 5 years, and then you'll face yearly adjustments. Whether it's up or down is going to depend on what the rates are doing. So adjustable rate mortgages are a little bit tricky. If you're only planning on staying into it for 5 years, that's one thing. But if you need to stay into it for longer, you're either going to need to refinance, and that could potentially be at a higher rate, or you're going to be stuck with the adjustable rate changes over the years. Now, we did find some VA and FHA. The VA is sitting at 7.35%, very similar to the 30-year conventional. The nice thing with the VA for those persons who are veterans and or current service members is that you have zero down. So it lets you get into a home without a lot of expenditure there. It is going to cost you a little bit more per month though. And right now that's at $689. Like I said, very similar to the 30-year conventional fixed. The FHA, which you can do as little as 3.5% down, is sitting right now at 7.27%. or approximately between $659 and $660 per month for principal and interest. Now, there is another program or another loan that they've talked about out there that I've seen mentioned, and that is a piggyback loan. Your rates are still the same, but this is going to be the trick part. Basically, a piggyback loan is an 80-10-10. What that is 80% is your primary mortgage, 10% is how much you place down, and then 10% is the so-called piggyback loan, which has several advantages. Because it's a lower amount, say you take $500,000, you have $400,000 loan, $50,000 you do down for your 10%, and then $50,000 for your piggyback. It's only $50,000. So potentially the bank could actually give you a lower interest rate because of the fact that that is a smaller loan. It also helps on your bigger loan, because the thing of it is it's less risk for that bank. But even if you have the 30-year, say the 30-year fixed, because this is where it's going to go for is your conventional loan, is still at 7.36%. Your piggyback, your 10% there could be at a 5 or 6%. So it's going to save you there. Additionally, it's going to save you is because you'll actually, in theory, have 20% down. Your primary mortgage is only 80%. So the 20% down, in theory, is actually going to mean you won't need a private mortgage insurance. So that is also going to save you on a monthly basis. So you have a couple different ways to save there. So the piggyback loan may be something that is beneficial for you if you're able to do the initial 10% down and do a conventional loan there. Now, if you're looking to buy or sell, buyers, look, we have mortgage brokers that can help you with loan programs that will help you get into that home that you are going to be happy with that you can also afford. Once they tell you how much you can afford and that you're going to be content with, then we can work to find that home for you and make sure we represent you through the process. Sellers, first thing we're going to do and the key thing that you're going to want is to know how much that home is worth. In order to do that, you need a convertible market analysis. We will do one for free for you and also basically not only additionally telling you what your home could get on the market, but approximately how long it should take to sell. Now, our contact information is below. Make sure while you're there, you click like, subscribe, and also the bell notification so as we produce new videos, that you're able to also be notified of those. Once again, we're here to help you out. Thank you and have a good day.